Welcome to StormCast, the official Warhammer Age of Sigmar podcast.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the show. I am Duncan Rhodes, and I am joined today by two people. We've got Diarmuid right here. How's it going, man?
Not bad.
Awesome, awesome. We've got Rory as well over here. How's it going?
Oh, it's lovely to be here. I enjoyed particularly my Easter egg appearance in the previous episode where I knocked on the door while you were recording.
that did happen. Yeah. But today is a very important and a powerful episode.
Yes.
If you will, because today we're having a character throwdown. Who is the greatest general?
We were like, Sigmar. If only there was some kind of organized system for determining the best of sort of fantasy characters in a sort of battle setting.
Yeah.
And we couldn't think of one, so we decided the cut and thrust of debates would be the best way to settle it.
Yeah. And of course, the answer is Archaon, and we'll see you next
time. There we go. Yeah, it's a very short episode.
So Duncan, are you going to sustain your point at all?
Yeah.
Come
at me.
It's true. That's what a weakling does. It's like, it's true to Archaon, but like, no, just self-evidently. Yeah. It's beyond your comprehension.
That's right. He does have a weakness, though.
Yeah.
Because he's only got three of the four Chaos Gods.
True.
I think he's got a little bit of Stannish, but it's like tucked away as like a mini head, which is like, it's me.
Okay.
I'm missing, but I've still contributed. Yeah. Yeah. Much like I am on the podcast nowadays.
Yeah, he's clearly the best general. I mean, if it wasn't for him, it would be the Age of Myth. Dare I say, if it wasn't for him, it would be Warhammer Fantasy Battle.
Ooh.
He is the strongest of them all.
That's an interesting point. It's an interesting point. But what if he got off Dorgar and he was on foot? Because that dragon's doing a lot for
much more useful.
Yeah,
you have to reach things.
Yeah. Rather than just being like a sort of shiny pointing object, it would be. Yeah,
you can gesture at the people you want Dorgar to eat.
Although probably being on Dorgar is obviously very safe for him because I wouldn't trust Dorgar not to eat me. Uh-huh. I mean, doesn't Dorgar eat in three greater demons?
He's got three rows. It is quite cool actually because each one of them does like a different thing, doesn't it? When you fight and stuff, you attack with each of them differently, and if they're the one that like goes om and eats something, does different stuff, doesn't it?
And it spits stuff out. Yeah. It's like a really, really powerful camel with wings.
Yes, it's the only creature that spits things out. It's a
exactly.
Camel.
And that's why Archaon is the best.
There are winged creatures that spit.
Wow.
Just say the word dragon.
I'm assuming by your impertinence that you have some other pretender to the throne.
Diarmuid, thanks for getting us warmed up. Okay, it's time to get a professional head. I'm going to talk to you
very serious
about why Nagash is the best character. As you know, I collect Chaos. If I want, to be honest, like part of me is going to be like any Beast Lord.
I was surprised you didn't mention a particularly famous goat.
Well, I sort of like the idea that the Beastmen are so anarchic that none of them are that famous or well known because they're all sort of live these short, brutal lives, which is really cool. But I digress, and I'm going to continue to digress. Beastmen are so great. I love the idea that you have all these.
Someone does probably herald over the Beastmen. Surely there is some sort of exalted
Grand Marshal of
the Apocalypse.
Or someone who rules over all of them.
Yes.
With extreme power.
Yes. Yeah.
Do you reckon he gave himself that name?
Someone, almost certainly, yeah. I think we mentioned in the episode with Phil Kelly that obviously that's just an abridged version of his name.
Yeah.
I'm sure it's much longer.
However, on reflection, I thought a character I come back to, and it won't be for the reasons you expect, is Nagash. So Nagash is, a lot of reasons people might say they like Nagash, he's the Grand Necromancer, he's the incarnate sort of essence of death, he's so powerful that the Chaos Gods are deeply frightened of him, he has all these grand plans. The reason I think Nagash is the best character in Warhammer Age of Sigmar is because he has never gotten over anything in his entire life, and I relate to that so hard.
You hold a grudge then.
If you've ever had that moment where you sit down and be like, one day I'm going to show them, that's Nagash's character, where like you're this incarnate like deity, like every moment of your life is this shimmering, perfect sort of sublimeness where you are like one with the very essence of what you are. Like there, you are a literal entity, like 1/8 of this entire reality consists of you. And you're still like, that person said something mean about me. I'm going to really punish him. Imagine the depths of pettiness you need to be that. Imagine being so vindictive.
Imagine pushing in front of him in a queue by accident.
Yeah.
Next thing you know, you're eternally chained to a baguette that you can never quite reach.
But will he say anything like right there and then, or will he like wait? You know, be very right. No, it's fine. It's fine.
Yeah,
you wait. And then you're like going, yeah.
Nagash is very much like a letter to the editor kind of sort. We're like, dear sir or madam. Yeah.
Imagine my disappointment when.
So Nagash for me is great because it's like you have someone who just makes plans and accomplishes them as well, unlike a certain Grand High Marshal of the Apocalypse.
Yeah. He makes plans. I mean, so...
Yeah,
so
go on.
The reason you like... I get the way you can like Nagash. You are an incredibly petty person, and you look like him. But,
wow. Well, all right, I don't want to time you out.
He's just the biggest nihilist of the mortal realms. Yeah. He believes in nothing, really.
Oh, that's really cool, Diarmuid.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
But he gets a lot of girls with that line. He's there hanging out with D-Unets, being like, smoking a cigarette and being like, yeah, it just doesn't really mean anything to me. Like, yeah.
The Games Workshop does not encourage smoking.
Yeah. Because he's a bad guy, so like, it's okay.
He rocks up, the sort of guy that would hit the jukebox with his hand and it would start working again. Yeah. Except he would, and the jukebox would be a realm and it would die.
His fist strikes the jukebox and it's suddenly it just, all it can do is wail in the voices of the damned. It's good track.
Yeah. No one really actually likes him. They're all just a little bit scared of him.
Yeah. Much like cool. You, Diarmuid.
Okay, Duncan. Who have you brought to the fray?
Okay.
Who is going to stand there and challenge these two?
A hero. On the sort of, bear in mind, we've mentioned two basically godlike entities, right? Two colossal striding figures.
You've transcended huge eras and apocalyptic events. Who have you brought to the table?
I've not brought someone to stand, I brought someone to fly.
Okay.
Brock Grunson. Floating in with his robo suit and his big chainsaw.
Really?
Yeah. He's got guns in his face.
Yes.
Come on, dude's got a gun mustache. Beard gun.
That is amazing. Right.
That's just right. As good as doing magic. Having two small pistols in your face.
It's like, you know, they can see them all casting their spell. No, you're not casting a spell now. He shot you with his face. And he's got another gun on his arm. He's got a gun over top of his head.
It's true, he does have five guns. As good as being a god,
To entertain this?
Yes.
God of death, you can't, like, that's all he can do. Like, you can just kill stuff.
It's true, he hasn't even got one gun.
Yeah. Can it, like, that's it. That's it. He can't make fire, can he?
Well, I suppose he can, the necroquake, he elevates above it.
He can't make life, you know. He can make unlife. But life, maybe that's the one thing that Nagash really wants. If he could do that, then maybe he could get over himself.
So what is it about his... you've said he's well-armed.
He
is an awesome
cool
looking
robot
model.
Suit.
Mm-hmm. What is it about him that you think makes him such a great general?
I quite enjoy his background story. That basically, he was a no-one, you know, because in Caradhran society, it's all about you got to prove your worth. Right?
Yeah,
to get anywhere. And he's like, you know, he's the son of a guy who wanted to be an Arcanaut, but he just wasn't good enough. So he ended up just being a dock worker. And he'd always be there, like, cleaning the ships, you know, the character.
And James Gaines Workshop says there's nothing wrong with being a dock worker.
No, I think, like, it's the classic underdog story, right? You can see the ship coming in laden with gold and stuff like that. And he's there, like, you know, wanting to polish the boots and, you know, like, shine the ship up and stuff like that. You
Carrying
know,
but, a like, sheaf of papers with mustache gun written on the top. Right. Of me, like, your ideas will never go anywhere, kid. Get out of here.
Then he'd go back and he'd tell his kid, like, all these amazing things I've seen. And his kid's like, I want to be one of those. I want to be an Arcanaut. And not only is he an Arcanaut, he's the best Arcanaut because he's risen all the way to the top of the chain and made so much money. He is minted. So I think it's like a sort of underdog story. Yeah, it's a classic. I enjoy that little bit of background stuff. And now he's floating around in a big suit of armour and that's pretty sweet.
It is funny that he's sort of like, you have all these great ancient beings and there's like this new money being like, I've bought my way in. Hello, punch. Yeah,
that's right. He's the kind of guy that Archaon would fly in and start doing a big speech about how he's going to destroy the realm, and halfway through Brock would shoot him in the head and then take all the bits of gold Stormcast armour.
Just be
there
sort of
something.
Prying the gem out of his...
Archaon is... cool and be like, money means nothing to me, in a really badass kind of way. And then he would definitely win that fight as well, by the way. He'd roll the double sixes to kill him with his sword.
Is that right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, as Rory said earlier, if only there was a way that we could actually pit these people, sort of almost garner their stats and pit them against each other.
Work out, but that would be incredibly complicated.
You need to have an element of randomness to it.
So yes.
So, I guess you could draw cards from a deck and,
Or roll a 12-sided dice or something.
I think the problem is, this would be easy to solve if you just agreed with one of us and done the gentlemanly thing.
Yeah. I was expecting to say Sigmar. Because then I'd prepared for when. So yeah, but Sigmar. I've got quite a lot. He threw his hammer.
But Sigmar, he's like what a loser, throws his hammer at Sarket. Like, geez, man, like, come on.
He's not a loser anymore. He's currently winning back most of the Mortal Realms.
That is true.
Why am I now supporting him?
That is true. Although his Stormcast project's gone a little bit wrong, hasn't it?
Yes, we did learn from Phil Kelly.
Made of a bit of a boo boo there.
Yeah, you see, if you start off by deciding that all your servants are to be like deathless, bitter revenants, then you're sorted. It's like Nagash's like, this is great, mission accomplished. Yeah. how's your emotions doing, bud? Horrible. Grand. That was my intention all along. See ya.
Yeah. I could totally see him saying that. Yeah. Magnificent hat and all. I can see him. Oh, great. That's really well done, like, everyone.
Hey guys. Yeah.
A bony thumbs morning. Up. Yeah. As he floats away.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, though. Another general that I really like, I think is particularly cool, is Alariel.
Okay.
It's not really for like background or anything like that, but I think the model is amazing. I love the giant war beetle.
I love that it's a manifestation of lots of mini beetles.
Yeah, and it can like just disappear and reappear elsewhere as she like jumps and lands on it. So I think that's really cool. And Lariel's a gorgeous model as well, even with a big creepy sort of like wood arm thing. But
I quite like how she's sort of genuinely quite horrifying, but in a very abstract way, where it's like, I think the Silver Death's very much like trees, but like the least cuddly trees ever.
Yes.
It's like you can imagine a bunch of like maybe wanderers chaining themselves to trees and the trees sort of stab and tearing the wanderer off and be like,
I don't need you to fight my battles for me.
You'd be quite spiteful if the most powerful being in your universe sort of tore apart your entire existence like Archaon Death did. I can also add at this point that he's also taller than all of your heroes. Yours doesn't count because he's flying. He's incredibly short.
Yeah, but if you took him off Dorgar, you can't count Dorgar. Dorgar's someone else. Like, you're saying Archaon's the greatest general, not Dorgar.
I can't draw an analogy without appealing to someone else's intellectual property. You can have Ying without Yang.
Maybe we
you
should
wouldn't
like
rip a wizard like Nagash of his staff, would you?
It's true. Right. Or his hat, which is another key part of his accoutrements.
It is that fabulous hat.
He's trying to be taller than Arkane with that hat, but that's not working.
No,
maybe we could separate, because obviously this is quite highly charged. Perhaps we could separate our emotions from these characters and maybe pick like one that we can all agree is pretty cool, a pretty rad dude.
Duncan, if Warhammer has taught me anything, it's never to ever separate my emotions from any part of this hobby. Just always take everything unbelievably personally.
Well, for example, we could just say like, I don't know, a war girl.
Feel like you're very much pandering to me.
Just a generic one of those and I'd be all right with that. And then we could like form a sort of an alliance, if you will.
Why would I choose the Wargor? Archaon's totally his boss.
Okay. All right.
I'm clearly not over
something
this.
Something else then. All right. What about Vandas Hammerhand?
Oh, he is very cool. Yes. In fact, I got a lot of new respect for him when I learned about the... do you know about the visions he has?
Oh, yeah. He sees the lightning man in his dreams. And yes. Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
That is pretty cool.
Like Vandas, that he's like the shiny, happy hero who's suddenly going through this weird PTSD from being like the first Stormcast Eternal. That's quite fun as a twist. Like, the idea is like, if Vandas had lived to 200 years, he'd like probably have a happy life. But at the moment, he's like, oh, God. Another day at work.
Don't want to do this anymore.
Sigma sends him an email being like, hey, Vandas, just when you're getting on Monday, do purge the Chaos Realms. I noticed you've not done it yet. If you can action this as soon as possible, thanks.
Get them as soon as possible, that'd be great. What about Skarbrand? He punched Khorne.
So Skarbrand, again, appeals to me for the same reason Nagash, where like, he's someone that's never gotten over anything his entire life. He's just walking around full of like a deep anger all the time.
Do you think he's angry with himself for punching Khorne?
I think he probably doesn't regret it. He's like, you know when you like see those sort of little men that lose fights, as I often do, being when I'm down having a good old bit of pugilism, men unlike me who always I'm quite quiet and normal about fights, but no. he's like, oh, I would have got him. I wasn't ready. Yeah. He's got all the other blood first. Like, mate.
Had dirt in my eye.
Yeah.
They're all on his side.
I was tired. I had some gluten.
Not crying. Hay fever.
Yeah.
After he hit me in the face, then a hay fever came.
Yeah. I told him no jabs. Tore my wings off. It was rubbish.
No one can't reach top shelf. I was trying to think if I could devolve from who I would choose. I do think there's something about the destruction generals because, similar to Archaon, they do just want to destroy things.
Smash stuff.
Yeah, I feel like he would otherwise be a destruction person if he wasn't just sort of had all this chaos.
Because destruction guys like have fun, and Arcane like forbids himself fun. From smiling or enjoying anything.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah.
Doesn't he sound great?
Yeah.
He probably has the same haircut as me.
Yeah. No pair of glasses. Yeah. Yeah. Hey guys, it's me, Archeon. Basically, if you could just destroy the realms, that'd be great. Yeah.
There's a voice mod in his helmet, so it sounds way cooler.
Yeah, it just was all echoey in there. Yeah. Well, guys, I'm seeing the symbol for time, which means we are settled that Nagash is the best general. Thanks so much. Wrap it up there.
What? Yeah. That is outrageous.
I don't think this is over. I don't know. But there is someone behind the camera right now, a camera crew man, Raphael,
yes.
If you will, who might be able to decide the casting vote. So Raph, if you could raise your hand up, is it going to be Brock Grunson?
Is it going to be... No, is it going to be Nagash?
Sound's gone right up.
Yes, no, it's not done. It's like,
yeah. It was amazing, even before you finished talking.
Retail, is it Archeon? He's put his hand up, everybody. He has put his hand up. That means I am tonight's winner. That means I will be winning the... nothing, I don't
care. And on
because,
that bombshell.
Because like Archeon, I don't care. I did it to see you both burn.
Yeah, you turned up. You cared enough to turn up to make sure that you won, but then secretly you don't care.
Yeah, I'll let you rebuild so I can come back and beat you again. And again, fraternity.
Okay. Well, I look forward to it. Well, thank you very much for having me on.
That sounds marvellous. I hope you guys have enjoyed the show today. It's been quite a crazy one. But why don't you guys tell us who you think the best general is for Age of Sigmar on the Age of Sigmar Facebook page. Post it underneath this video. Tell us who you think is best. Obviously, cool. It's Brock, right? Or Vandas. It's not Archeon. Don't let it go to his head. It'll be impossible in the office if it does. I hope you guys enjoyed the show. We'll see you next time on StormCast.